Hi, so today we're going to look at Roger Federer's Sabre return. You may remember in video 26 we looked at how to be an aggressive returner. Well, this summer Roger Federer has taken that to a whole new level. You up for this?
Yes, let's go for it. Wait.
Great.
What's happened to your brilliant beard?
My beard? Well, that was obviously my US Open beard. So the US Open finished on Monday, so I've shaved it off. It's probably halfway down the Thames by now.
That's just silly. Why didn't you just grow it or even shave half of it off?
Anyway, some people are saying it's exciting and fun, this Sabre return, but other people are saying it's disrespectful to the opponent. Anyway, let's check it out.
Oh, and look at that. Oh. How about that?
Thank you. Disrespectful? What a load of rubbish! The Sabre is both skillful and tactical. Isn't that what winning tennis matches is all about? I mean, it would be like Jeremy saying I was being disrespectful in our match yesterday because I kept hitting to his backhand.
Hey, what was wrong with my backhand yesterday? It was alright.
Every time I hit to it, you missed and I won the point.
It wasn't that bad.
It was pretty shocking. What do you think, cameraman?
What backhand?
Oh! Special school, 'cause I am such a fool, and I don't need a single book to teach me how to read. Who needs stupid books? They are for petty crooks, and I will learn by studying the lessons in my dreams. So turn off the TV, 'cause that's what others see, and movies are as bad as eating chocolate ice cream. They only sicken me. Don't let me play for ball. I'll sack the quarterback and jack your brother.
You forgot to do it.
Personally, I think the Sabre is brilliant. It's tactical because it keeps your opponent guessing, and if they're a little bit weak mentally, it's going to unsettle them. And it's also intelligent because as the server, it takes a little bit longer to recover from that serve, so you're always going to be rushed setting up and playing the next shot. And as the returner hitting the Sabre, you're so far up the court when you hit it, you can take up an excellent position at the net well in time for the next shot as well. And most of all, it's really exciting to watch and a lot of fun to try out.
So first up, you're going to look like you're setting up normally, but you're going to wait until the server has released the ball and then their eyes will be focused on the ball and not on you. There's not a lot of time, so try and use two or three big, fast steps before you go into your split step. Then it's about seeing the ball clearly, a compact short swing, contact out in front, and then continuing that forward momentum to move yourself up to the net. If things go well, you can then take control of the point. I found I like to put a bit of slice on the ball, especially if the serve was short and bounced up, but Federer often tries to hit through the ball flat or with topspin.
Yeah, so that net called one a hit was a killer, wasn't it?
It was quite, wasn't it?
Yeah, Federer hit one of those against Darcis at the US Open.
Very good.
Shock and awe.
handled the saver pretty good, got to net. Trust his volleys. Yeah, I think if you got those skills, you're comfortable with the half volley, you're comfortable seeing the ball and playing at the net, then this is definitely something you could use.
Yeah, but not all the time.
No. Second serves, first serves, I wouldn't use it on the first serve unless you're, you know, maybe at rec level, club level, you might find servers not that strong. You might be possible to use it on the first, but more a second serve tactic and certainly something you'd use sporadically.